I don't know if this is a direct effect of conflict, but I think that women's empowerment was quite strikingly low. It was sometimes hard to even get women to be willing to consent for themselves, which is difficult coming from New York, where we expect the woman to consent for herself and her family can be involved, but she actually has to make the decision. And often she herself was not really willing to do that, and often deferred to her husband. And for me, ethically, it was important that she understand what was happening. And then, you know, I think another thing was that I realized how connected I was to this nonverbal communication. Obviously, I don't speak Dinka, but when you don't speak the language, at least you can make eye contact and smile. And I would assume that this is a result of chronic conflict, but people are very, very stoic, and there's not a reflexive smile. And I realized that to connect with someone nonverbally, it's hard to do that when they don't smile as they're shaking your hand or immediately smile in response to your smile. And I think it's just cultural, but that was sort of striking when I got there. And it made it harder for me, or much more challenging, to find a way to get my patients to trust me without me being able to say anything to them. And I don't know that this is a result of war. I mean, maybe it's just cultural, but it seemed very striking, and more so than other places that I've been that are stoic and that are suffering but not in active conflict.